Here's a conventional 2-ton air conditioner, a Goodman to be exact. And here is a soft starter module that I would like to install. Not sponsored. Hyper Engineering SureStart model SS1B08-16SN. It's the 230 volt single phase model. As mentioned, I did buy this unit with my own money, so no one sponsored the filming of this video. Now, why would I do this? Well, this unit utilizes what is known as a scroll type compressor. It's reliable, it's used everywhere, but each time this thing fires up, it momentarily draws a large surge or inrush of electric current. This surge is considered normal, but it may cause lights to flicker in the house, and for those with small or mid-sized generators, it may even render the air conditioner impossible to start. For me though, I want my old system to last, and it just so happens that new regulations on AC installs will be implemented January of 2025. So I wanted to go over the steps and results with you today. There will be video and schematics to try to keep things clear for you. Yours will likely be different, at least in some ways, so keep that in mind. As you can see on the outside unit's nameplate, this single-phase 230 volt unit is rated to draw up to just over 58 amps on startup. The term LRA shown here stands for locked rotor amps, which is the maximum current drawn by the compressor motor when its internal rotor shaft is still locked in place at startup. This current does drop substantially as soon as the compressor spins up to speed. The RLA, or running load amps, as you can see, is way lower. Disclaimer, warning, only qualified or licensed technicians should attempt what I'm about to do here. Electricity can be dangerous. Let's confirm the inrush current. First, we'll fully depower the outside AC unit by pulling the main disconnect. Next, we'll remove the access panel to expose the control wiring. We'll now clamp over the compressor common wire, repower, and turn on the system. Here's our inrush measurement. Just over 60 amps on startup. That's quite a bit. Now your system should have its own wiring schematic somewhere. This one's located behind the outside access cover and looks like this. It is pretty busy looking, so I created another schematic that we'll refer to as we go to try to simplify things a bit. My existing setup has no existing hard or soft starters pre-installed. It's a bare bones setup. This is still a lot to look at, so let's check this out in smaller bites. Okay, everything in the box is within the outside AC unit. We have the contactor, the compressor, and low side copper refrigerant line from the house, the condenser with the high side copper refrigerant lines, and an inline dryer included. That goes back to the house. Plus two protective low and high pressure switches. Then the last two items are the cooling fan to remove all the heat from the condenser, and lastly, the starting capacitor that starts both the compressor and fan motors. Now to connect things up. From the house, we have our 240 volt single phase main power feed that arrives at the contactor L1 and L2 terminals via two 120 volt supply wires. Plus there's a grounding wire for the chassis. And finally from the house, we have a low voltage control circuit loop that runs in series through the high pressure cutout switch, the low pressure cutout switch, then through the contactor energizing coil and back to the house. Within the unit, the always energized T1 terminal sends power to the common black wires of both the fan and the compressor. The T2 terminal of the contactor sends power to the red run wire of the compressor and the C common terminal of the capacitor. The yellow wire from the compressor runs to terminal H, HERM, of the capacitor. The purple wire from the fan runs to the C common terminal of the capacitor. And finally, the brown wire from the fan runs to the F fan terminal of the capacitor. It's important to realize that in this configuration, with this single throw contactor, that anything connected to the T1 terminal is always live, which means that there is always at least 120 volts present at most terminals of this unit, so be careful. Just another reason to disconnect the safety plug when servicing a unit like this. I first proceeded to take a few pictures of the existing setup before doing anything. It's good to have a backup to look at if there's any confusion. The steps I took, with the main power disconnect removed from the wall and the access cover removed. After a few minutes with my hand only in contact with the insulated handle of the screwdriver, I discharge any possible residual electricity from the run capacitor by directly crossing over the terminals with the metal blade of the screwdriver against all three capacitor terminals. The instructions provided do not tell you to do this. Rather, they say in mine to allow 2 minutes to discharge run capacitor before disconnecting. Now, following the written guide, step one, we already disconnected all voltage to the HVAC unit. Step two, secure the base for the SureStart inside the control box. You'll need to find a suitable location for your module and the mounting base. One needs to be mindful of where the mounting plate screws exit from the other side of the sheet metal panel. On mine, there were some high voltage wires for the fan on the other side, as you can see. I compensated for those by adjusting the position of the screws so as not to create a possible short circuit scenario. Okay, I mounted the module before connecting the wires up. You can do whatever works for you. So on to the connections. Step 3. Remove the compressor run wire from the contactor or run capacitor terminal, as applicable. Step 4. Strip the compressor run wire at least half an inch. Step 5. Attach the compressor run wire to the SureStart run winding terminal. Step 6. Attach brown wire supplied with the SureStart to the run capacitor terminal on the SureStart. Step 7. Identify the cable connecting the contactor and the run cap. Remove the connection to the run cap. Attach the flagged end of the brown wire to the same terminal of the run cap. This is the common C terminal for dual compressor fan capacitors. Step 8. Attach the black wire supplied to compressor common on the SureStart green terminal connector. Step 9. Attach the flagged end of the black wire to the compressor common on the T side of the contactor. Step 10. Attach the blue wire supplied to the start winding on the SureStart green terminal connector. Step 11. Attach the flagged end of the blue wire to the other terminal of the run capacitor. Ensure that this terminal of the capacitor also joins to the start winding of the compressor. This is HERM H terminal for dual compressor fan capacitors. Step 12. Attach the red wire supplied to the active terminal of the SureStart. Step 13. Remove the loose wire from step 7 from the active input of the contactor and attach the stripped end of the active wire in its place. Now, I did elect to modify this step slightly in that instead of connecting the active wire to the contactor using the screw and the bare wire, I did use a yellow terminal spade connector with my crimp tool instead. The terminal specifications are shown. And step 14. Apply power to the equipment and cycle to ensure proper operation. Note, the SureStart device could take up to 6 starts to optimize performance. Okay, on to startup 1. The current is, and on 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and we'll do one more. This module seems to be making a huge difference on startup current. In fact, on this unit, the inrush has dropped to about 1/3 of the original measured amount from before the install. Remember to follow your schematics and your provided information with your equipment. Hopefully, this rather involved video has helped you in some way. If it has, or you at least found some value in it, please like and share to get this out. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you know what to do. Have a great one, everybody. See you in the next one.